Hello and welcome to Nikolai's genetics lessons, and in this video I'm going to compare half versus full collateral relationships. Imagine we have a family, so his mother, his father, and this family has two children. Can be of the same sex or of the different sex, it doesn't matter. So children would grow and would also marry and would have children. And now let's take a look at the different situation where, say, we have female. This female marries a man. They would have a child. That child would marry another man and would have their own child. But also, this female may break her marriage with this person and may marry another male, where she also may have another child. The child would grow and marry a female and may have child of their own. So what would be coefficient of relatedness in this family and in this family? So here we see siblings, two parents. Here we see half siblings that related only through their mother but would have different fathers. So how people in this pedigree would relate to each other? Daughter would receive 50% of her genes from mother's side, another 50% from her father's side. Her brother also would receive 50% from the mother side and 50% from the father side. And this gives us coefficient of relationship between two full siblings also as 50%. How related would be niece and uncle? Let's find out. First line here, second pass goes here, and third pass comes here. So we would have 1/2 in a power of 3. But we have also another pathway here. So this is going to be the first one. Here is going to be the second and the third. So we have to add these two probabilities to share the same genes. And this is going to be also 1/2 in a power of 3. That would give us together, so 1/2 in a power of 3 would be 1/8 plus 1/8 would give us 1/4 or 25%. So uncle and niece, so niece and uncle would be related by 25% or would share 25% of the genes that they got from the common ancestors. How two first cousins would be related? Let's find out. So we have to add another path here, red line, and another green line here. So once again, 1, 2, 3, 4 lines here that goes through their grandmother, and 1, 2, 3, 4 lines here that goes through the common ancestor, the grandfather. So this is going to be 1/2 in a power of 4 plus 1/2 in a power of 4. That would give us a probability 1/8 or 12.5% would be coefficient of relationship between two cousins. Now let's compare with what we see here. Two half siblings would share the same mother but would have different fathers. Another example could be when two half siblings would have the same father but would have different mothers. So in our example, these two half siblings would share genes that they got from their mother. So coefficient of relationship between two half siblings would be one half in the power of 2. So this is going to be 1/4. So these two half siblings would share 25% of the common genes that they got through their mother or from their mother. Compare with coefficient of relationship or relatedness between two full siblings. Here 50%, here 25%. Now let's compare what would be coefficient of relatedness between half aunt and half nephew. So we have to add another line here, and we are going to get 1/2 in the power of 3. So coefficient of relatedness would be 1/8 or 12.5%. Compare with coefficient of relatedness between niece and uncle, which equals to 25%. So here we would have only half of that. And now let's compare coefficient of relatedness between two half cousins. We have to add another pass here, and we are going to have 1, 2, 3, 4 passes between these two half cousins. So we would have 1/2 in the power of 4, which going to be 1/16, which also would equal to 6.25%. So as you see, when we compare full collateral relationships, full collateral relatives with a half collateral relationship between half siblings, half nephew and aunt, half uncle and niece, or two half first cousins, if first full cousins would be related to each other as 12.5%, then two half cousins would be related by 6.25%. I hope my explanation were clear enough, so now you would be able to calculate collateral coefficient of relatedness between full relatives and half relatives. And this is all for today. Thank you for attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.